name is Ariane.
And I'm Shelby.
And we work at the Child Protection Center. Usually you see us in your classrooms, but now we're stuck at home just like you guys.
And I feel like a lot of the times when we're stuck inside all day, we don't really know how to deal with all the feelings and emotions that we're feeling with this really big situation that's happening right now. You might be feeling sad, you might be feeling confused, but the number one thing we're gonna talk about today is talking about stress. All right, Ariane, so what is stress?
Stress can be defined as so many different things, but stress is when there's so much going on and your body feels a little overwhelmed, maybe a little frustrated, you get a little frustrated inside, or you feel really worried. So Shelby, what are some things that can stress us out?
So when we talk about stress for you guys as kids, a lot of the times we feel stress at school, we can feel stress with homework and tests and all those things. But right now, the type of stress that you might be feeling can feel a little bit different. So right now we're not allowed to really leave our houses, we're not really allowed to go a lot of places. So you might be feeling that you're spending a lot of time inside with the same people all the time. So when we talk about stress, we want to figure out, how do we know when we're stressed? So Ariane, how do we figure out if our bodies are stressed out, if we're feeling stressed out, what are some things that we can feel or like look for?
So there's a lot of different things that we can look for, right? So the first thing for me is my hands get really sweaty. So they start feeling like really wet and maybe feeling like my hands are sweating. So that is maybe a sign that we're feeling a little stressed out. So when we're feeling really stressed, our brain is sending signals through our body telling us that something is feeling a little off. So a lot of times what we can see is our heart starts beating a little faster, maybe when we're feeling a little stressed out. Mm-hmm. Also our muscles can get really tense. So if you feel like you need a good stretch, maybe that could be just your body telling you, hey, feeling a little stressed out, maybe a little worried about something. Another thing that we can see is our breathing. Mm-hmm. So our breathing is normal usually, but maybe if we're feeling a little stressed out, we feel like we have to grasp for air a little bit more. Our breathing gets a little faster, which is maybe why our heart rate gets a little faster as well. Mm-hmm. More serious things that we can see too is maybe not sleeping very well. So going to sleep at nighttime, maybe it's really hard to sleep. Maybe your brain is thinking of so many different things that have happened that day or things that are making you feel a little stressed out. So these are all ways that our body can tell us, hey, I'm feeling a little stressed.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna give you different tools and different tips on how to kind of de-stress. So that's what we're gonna talk about next.
So here are some things that you guys can do right in the comfort of your own home if you're feeling that feeling of worry or stress or overwhelm. Here are some things that you can do. One really good tip is just going outside and doing some jumping jacks. I think that is a really nice thing, especially when we're stuck at home all day long. Getting some nice fresh air is a great idea, but make sure you ask your parents first.
Another great thing that you can do, since we're talking about being outside already, exercising is a really good one. Going on a walk is really, really important. I go on a walk at least twice a day. I think it's really important to keep spending time outside in nature, making sure that we're breathing in the fresh air. Going on walks with your family can be really fun too. I know I take my dog on a bunch of different walks during the day, and he loves it, and I do too, because it's getting me outside of my house.
I love that you bring up your dog, because petting my dog definitely helps me feel a little less stressed. Mm-hmm. Aside from petting my dog, sometimes I put in my music while I'm petting my dog, and I like to listen to music, and that can help me feel a lot less stressed too.
Another thing you can do is maybe try and learn a new skill. So drawing, writing in a journal is really, really fun. And you can also write about the feelings that you're feeling, because when you write about the stress that you're feeling, it kind of helps you release it. And it's like you're talking to somebody about it. And that's another thing we kind of want to talk about. If you are feeling really, really stressed, it's really important that we talk to our siblings, that we talk to our parents about the stress that we're feeling, because we don't want to feel like we're the only ones feeling all the stress and all the worry and being super nervous about everything that's going on. But we're going to give you some skills and some little tips on how to calm our bodies down. And you can do this with your family, you can do this with your brothers, your sisters, and your adults at home.
So this is called the Sea Life Calm Down. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you three ways to stretch your body or to breathe or to ways to really calm your body down, like Shelby said. So I want you guys to stand up with us, and we are going to learn the Sea Life Calm Down right now.
So now that you guys are up on your feet, we're gonna do what's called the starfish stretch together. Now the purpose of the starfish stretch is to stretch out your whole body, release all the tension in your neck, in your back, in your arms, in your legs, so we can try and relieve the stress that is physically being felt in our bodies. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're going to stretch your arms and your legs straight out, really, really far, like you are a starfish. Now, what we're gonna do is count down from 10, on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Now when you release, you should feel the calmness running through your body and trying to feel a little bit looser. And then we're gonna do it again. Ready? 1, 2, 3. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Awesome job.
Next, what we have is called the puffer fish puff. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a big deep breath from our bellies and we're gonna hold it for 10 seconds, okay? So what we're doing when we're doing the puffer fish puff is that we're really bringing all the oxygen into our bodies and through our brains, through our blood, through our whole bodies, and helping our breathing slow down, helping our heart rate slow down. So we're gonna do this together right now. So on the count of three, we're gonna take a deep breath in. I want your cheeks to puff out like a puffer fish, and we're gonna count down from 10. Ready? 1, 2, 3. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. We're gonna do that one more time. Ready? 1, 2, 3. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release. Good job.
So the last part of our Sea Life Calm Downs is called the clam cuddle. Now the purpose of the clam cuddle is to give yourself a big hug and tell yourself that everything is gonna be okay. Because during these stressful times, it's really hard to think into the future that everything is gonna be all right, but we wanna keep telling ourselves and giving ourselves some positive reminders that we will be okay. So give yourself a really big hug, tight, 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 squeeze, squeeze, squeeze for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Everything's gonna be okay.
And then release. Take a big deep breath. And we're gonna do it again. Ready? Really big hug, tight, 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 squeeze. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Everything is going to be okay.
And release. So those are our Sea Life Calm Downs. Hopefully they calm your body down, they calm your breathing down, you stretch your muscles a little bit, and it helps us relax a little bit more.
We wanna thank you guys so much for tuning in, so much for taking the time to really learn about what stress is, how that we can help ourselves during this time, how we can help others during this time. Hopefully this does not last much longer. We will see our beautiful smiling faces when school comes back either this year or next year, because guess what guys, we will get through this. We will all go back to normal and we hope to see you guys in your classes when school is back in session.
Thank you guys so much, bye.
Bye.